Father, in the name of Jesus, we glorify your name. We thank you tonight. Thank you for your people. Thank you for every brother, every sister. Thank you for every boy, every girl. Thank you for every family. Thank you for our friends who have joined us. Thank you for all our people everywhere. We know tonight is a special night. All these tears on the faces of your people will be wiped away. You will destroy the works of the devil. Every prayer that anybody prays here today, that prayer is answered. Sicknesses will go. Infirmities will vanish away. Powers of darkness will be crushed. Poverty will go away. Curses will go away. And you will bless everyone here tonight in Jesus' name. Joy unlimited. Joy unspeakable. Joy untold. The kind of joy we have never seen, we have never known. Bring it upon every life. Everybody on this ground will have a touch of the Lord. Will carry miracles back home. We thank you because we know you have answered. In Jesus' name we pray. I'm expecting a special K2 amen before you sit down there. God has answered your voice. He has heard you. Something will happen there today. God bless you. See that in the blessings of the Lord. There is an invitation the Lord has given you. You in particular tonight. You didn't know. The Lord was waiting for you before you came. He was waiting for you so that he can bless you. And tonight, blessings have come. Jeremiah tells us. Jeremiah chapter 33. I'm reading from verse 3. That's a kind of verse you'll not forget. 33:3. And it's Jeremiah. You will not forget this. It's a special message for you. It's a special declaration for you. It marks a special day in your life. Jeremiah chapter 33, verse 3. Call unto me. Are you sorrowful? Call unto me. Are you suffering? Call unto me. Are you depressed? Call unto me. Is there a yoke in your life? Call unto me. Are people making you run helter-skelter? Call unto me. The powers of darkness, are they waylaying you on the way? Call unto me. Are you sick? Call unto me. Are they giving you up? And they said you will die. That one is cancelled there today. Call unto me. And I will answer thee. What else are you looking for? That's the Almighty God talking to you. The Creator is talking to the creature. The Savior is talking to the sinner. The great physician is talking to the patient. And the one that can provide all your needs is talking to the poor. The deliverer is talking to the oppressed. And he says, call unto me, and I will answer thee and show thee great and mighty things. What's he telling you there? He said, a great miracle is happening to you today. This one, you will not escape this one. If you go to the right, miracle will run after you. You come to the left, miracle will run after you. We have been waiting for this day. We have been waiting for this time. The time when miracle will come. When power will come. When authority will come. And now the Almighty God has invited you. And he said, call unto me. And I will show you great things, mighty things, which thou knowest not. Tonight, the Lord is telling you, you can pray with confidence. You can talk to God with confidence. You can ask him with confidence. Because this is the Lord himself. He said, I know what you are going through. I know your heart ache. I know the pressure. I know the oppression. I know all the assets are going through. I know the hunger. And I know the poverty. And I know what happens in the night. I know what happened to you the other night. And you are thinking, how will I be delivered? It says your day of deliverance has now come. I see you there. God sees you there. The mighty power of God is going to touch you. That's why he's calling you. If you will respond, if you will say, yes, Lord, here I am. I come and I call and I pray, that prayer will be answered. Call unto me. He said me is the only one that can solve your problem. There is no name under heaven by which you can be saved. No name that can heal every sickness, take every infirmity away. There is no name that can break every yoke and destroy every work of the devil. It's the one that says, call unto me. And then he gives you assurance. He says, authority from heaven, confidence from heaven. And he says, I will answer you. You in particular, if you have never got any prayer answered, tonight is the night of answered prayer. Am I talking to somebody there today? If you have never seen miracle, tonight is the night of miracle. A special miracle. A specific miracle. A definite miracle. The one that has your name attached unto it. And that's why God said, I will answer thee. That's you in particular. I said you in particular. Ah, this is your day. I said this is your day. And then he says, and I will show you. He will show you something. He'll say, come and see. You will see. If you are blind, your eyes will open. He says, come and see. If you are lame, you rise up and walk. He says, come and see. If you brought anybody deaf and dumb, their ears will open, their tongue will be loosed. If there's any tuberculosis there that is killing you, that death will vanish away. Life will come. Because it says, I will show you great and mighty things which thou knowest not. He said, what you have never known, what you have never seen, what you have never felt, what you have never got. Tonight is that night. Number one, I will save you. All your sins will wipe away. The guilt will take away. The oppression will take away. The judgment it will take away. Number one, I will save you. Number two, I will heal you. Somebody there is getting healed tonight. I said, somebody there is getting healed tonight. If you call, if you tell him, if you shout it out, he will say, Lord, I am here. And you show him where the sickness is. You show him where that oppression is. He says, call unto me, and I will answer you. One, I will save you. Two, I will heal you. Three, I will cleanse you. You see, there are times we feel dirty. Can I come in the presence of God? I remember what I did. I remember I rolled in a spiritual mud. I feel dirty in my soul. I feel dirty in my mind. I feel dirty in my spirit. It says, call unto me. I will cleanse you. The blood of Jesus will wash you. It will wash you whiter than snow. I will save you. I will heal you. I will cleanse you. I will deliver you. It says there's no yoke that will not be broken tonight. I have the definite assurance in my heart. As I know that 2 and 2 equals 4, I know that you and deliverance, you are together. Because he says, I will deliver you. I'm even seeing you now. And I see the miracle on your forehead. I see the deliverance right there. Yes, I see your wife there. I see your children there. Deliverance has come to your family. Every yoke is broken. All the powers of darkness are crushed away from your life. And he says, I will bless you. Somebody there today, any kind of blessing you have come for, he says, I will bless you. He says, I will provide for you. Poverty will go. Somebody there, poverty will go. Joblessness will go. I don't have anything to eat. That thing has turned around tonight. He will provide for you. And then he says, I will sanctify you. You know, sometimes when we believers come like this, it's like, I bring my friend. He will bless your friend. He will bless you. I bring my neighbor. He will bless your neighbor. He will bless you. Everybody here today, you will not escape miracle. Whatever you need, believers there. I said, believers there. He will sanctify you. I will save you. I will heal you. I will cleanse you. I will deliver you. I will bless you. I'll provide for you. I will sanctify you. Look at this again. Call unto me, and I will answer thee and show thee great and mighty things which thou knowest not. I'm talking to you tonight on praying confidently for supernatural wonders. Praying confidently. Tonight there's no doubt. Tonight there's no unbelief. Tonight there is no pass or maybe. Because it's the Almighty Himself that calls you. It's the Almighty Himself that says He will answer your prayer. It's the one that says, call, and I will answer you, and I will show you great and mighty things. Things you have never known. Praying confidently for supernatural wonders. Look at verse 6. Look at verse 6 of that same chapter 33. Behold, I will bring it health and cure. And I will cure them and will reveal unto them the abundance of peace and truth. You see what the Lord said he will do? He said whatever sickness is there, HIV AIDS will be healed tonight. And tomorrow you go for checkup, and the medical exam will tell you now it's negative. No more HIV AIDS. Congratulations, you are here tonight. Because he says in verse 6, I will bring it health and cure. I will cure them and reveal unto them the abundance of peace and truth. In verse 8, I will cleanse them from all their iniquity, whereby they have sinned against me. And I will pardon all their transgressions, all their iniquities, whereby they have sinned and whereby they have transgressed against me. Look at verse 9. And it shall be to me a name of joy. Can you see your joy there? I see, can you see unspeakable joy there? That thing was written for you and waiting for you there. Ketu people, am I talking to you? Are you hearing your name? Are you seeing your picture? Are you seeing the promise for you? Tonight you will rejoice. A praise and an honor before all the nations of the earth. As you go back to your places tonight, they will see glory upon your life. See miracle upon your life. See the power of God upon your life. We shall hear of all the good that I shall do you unto them, and it shall fear and tremble for all the goodness and for all the prosperity that I procure unto it. The Lord has called you tonight. Anytime the Lord calls somebody specially, he always calls them to something good, something special, something specific. And tonight the Lord is calling you, and you'll be a partaker of the promises of God in Jesus' name. And say, look at this messenger the Lord has sent to you. And then look at all the message that this prophet is bringing to you tonight. The prophet tells us three things. Number one. Number two. Number three. And the prophet is coming from the presence of God. Number one, he looks at the problem. The problem. Number two, he comes with a promise. A promise. Number three, he comes with the power of God. Number one, the problem of sin and suffering. The problem of sin and suffering. Many people are confused. Many people say they don't understand. I go to church. What should this happen to me? I'm religious. What should this happen to me? I was born inside a Christian maternity. Why should this happen to me? And I've been reading Bible. Why should this happen to me? I'm baptized in water. Why should this happen to me? Jeremiah said, I'll tell you. It says, number one, is a problem of sin and suffering. Sin and suffering wedded together many years ago, since the time of Adam, and they have never divorced or separated. Where you find sin, you find suffering. And the prophet is telling us, he says, that's the problem. But you will not die in your problem. Your life will not stop at point one. Your life will move out of point one. Somebody is coming out of point one. What do you see there? Somebody coming out of point one. And that's why I'm going to call you at the end of the message. I say, come out of point one. Come out of your problem. You are coming out of problem. Am I talking to somebody there? Let me see your face. You are coming out. I come out. Say it with me. I come out. Your life will not end on point one. Point number two, the promise of salvation for your soul. The promise of salvation for your soul. Light will replace darkness. Joy will replace sorrow. Possibilities will replace impossibility. The goodness of God will replace all the harassing works of the devil. Salvation will replace your sin. God will carry you like a baby. He said, you are mine. I forgive you. I cleanse you. I change your life. You are not my child. He will put you in a special place in the kingdom of God. From tonight, are you hearing me? I said, are you hearing me? Is anybody hearing me there? I said, from tonight, joy, the joy of salvation, the joy of redemption, the joy of forgiveness, the joy of a new life, the promise of salvation for your soul. Your life will not stop there. Even if we stop there, salvation, that's wonderful, but we are not going to stop there until I lead you to number three. Power will come from heaven. Enter your heart. Enter your family. And we'll be searching. Where is sickness? Sickness will flee away. Where is satanic attack? Satanic attack will vanish away. Number three, the power of supernatural healing for the sick. The power of supernatural healing for the sick. I'm rejoicing with you already. I see what is going to happen to you. I see the power of God coming your way. Number one, the problem. Number two, the promise. Number three, tell me. Tell me. If it's going to be by your side there, I said number three, what is it? The power. The power of supernatural healing for the sick. Let's quickly look at number one. The problem of sin and suffering. Here the prophet is telling us. He said, yes, a promise is coming your way. But what's the root of your problem? What's the origin of your problem? Why is life like this? The problem of sin and suffering. Jeremiah chapter 3. Jeremiah chapter 3, I'm reading from verse 13. In Jeremiah chapter 3, verse 13, only acknowledge thine iniquity, that thou wast transgressed against the Lord thy God, and has scattered thy ways to the strangers under every green tree. And ye have not obeyed my voice, says the Lord. He says, that's the genesis of the problem. Don't dodge. And don't say, I don't know about that. He said, acknowledge, accept, and confess. And say, yes, I know the root of my problem. It's the problem of my sin. It's the problem of evil. He tells us in verse 25 of that same chapter 3. He said, we lie down in our shame. Our confusion covers us. For we have sinned. He said, we are confused because of sin. We are oppressed because of sin. We are being destroyed because of sin. Poverty will not allow us to eat because of sin. He said, because we have sinned. We have sinned against the Lord our God. We and our fathers from our youth even until this day and have not obeyed the voice of our God. It says that is the reason we're suffering. It says there's a connection between sin and suffering. If you say that the rain of blessing is not falling on your house, if you say that suffering will not allow you to rest, sickness and oppression will not allow you to breathe, it says, don't you know why? God is a good God. God is a wonderful God. It's not his will that anybody will suffer. He said, we cause the suffering for ourselves. We attracted the suffering to ourselves. He says, acknowledge that. You don't just be saying, I'm praying, I'm praying. He says, know the origin of your problem. Look at chapter 4, verse 18. Thy way and thy doings have procured these things unto thee. He said, this is thy wickedness, because it is bitter, because it reaches unto thine heart. He said, the sin is even pinching you now in your heart. It's like your heart will fly out. There is fear there. You are frightened. And there are enemies that are pursuing your life. And he said, but why? He said, you procured this to yourself. You attracted all this to your life. Look at chapter 4, verse 22. I must allow the prophet to talk to you directly, so that you don't say, okay, that is what Pastor so and so said. No, look at verse 22, chapter 4. For my people is foolish. They have not known me. They are sooty children. And it says they have none understanding. They are wise to do evil, but to do good they have no knowledge. He said their ways are crooked. They know how to steal. They know how to cheat. They know how to fight. They know how to oppress. They know how to attack. They know how to destroy other people. They are cunning and clever and crafty, and they can do evil, but to do right, to live good, and to live neat, that one they don't know. They know how to drink alcohol, and they know how to use whatever instrument to attack. They know how to kill. They don't know how to raise to life. They know how to defile. They don't know how to keep others clean. And he said, that's their problem. That's the reason why they are suffering. the problem of sin and suffering. Look at chapter 5. Jeremiah said, if you're not convinced yet that all this problem is not in vain, it's not just a joke, it's not accidental. I wish I were born in America. I wish I were born in London. If I was born in China, maybe I will not be suffering. They say this is our country. They say Nigeria. Nigeria. Why was I born in this place? Because now it's because I'm in Nigeria. Nigerian. That's why I'm suffering. Don't blame Nigeria. Look at chapter 5 verse 25. Jeremiah chapter 5 verse 25. Your iniquities have turned away these things, and your sins have withholding good things from you. It is not Nigeria that is your problem. You are the problem of yourself. Look at that verse again. Your iniquities are turned away. All these good things from you. Your sins, your evil, your wickedness, your violence, you're not being on the side of God. You separate yourself from the Creator, the one that can bless you, the one that can make your life good. That's why tonight you will come out of your problem. Somebody there, out. I said out. You will come out of the problem of sin, and then God will drive suffering away from your life. I thought Kechi will say amen. Look at verse 26 here. Chapter 5 verse 26. For among my people are found wicked men. What does he mean, among my people? So they go to church and they say they are my people. They are baptized in water. They say they are my people. They read the Bible. They say they are my people. Among my people are found wicked men. They lay wait as he that setteth snares, and they set a trap, and they catch men. Verse 27, as a cage is full of birds, so are their houses full of deceit. Their house is full of deceit. He said that is our problem. But thank God tonight, information is coming, revelation is coming, that God has sent a promise, and he has said this problem will not continue. God is sending a promise to you tonight, and the power of the Almighty God will back that promise. He will set you free. I said he will set you free. Are you still waiting for the promise? I said, are you waiting for the promise? You see, if there is something that's a problem, it's when the promise comes together with the power, united together, will drive every problem out of your life. You come out of that problem of sin and suffering, then the power of God will come upon you. Something good is happening to you tonight. You come out of darkness. I said you'll come out of darkness. You'll come to the light. You'll come out of the wickedness. You'll come to the goodness of God. You'll come out of evil. Come out of sin. Come out of transgression. Come out of iniquity. And you'll come into the forgiveness of the Lord. It will happen to somebody there, church. Where is the person there? Goodness coming upon your life. Mercy coming upon your life. Forgiveness coming upon your life. The smile of heaven. The smile of heaven will come upon your life. You will go out. You will be free as a feather. Guilt will go. Condemnation will go. You say, praise the Lord, I am free. Number two, the promise. The promise of salvation for your soul. You know, the people, when Jeremiah came, they were suffering. When they saw Jeremiah, they said, Jeremiah, come, come, come. Why? Why are these things happening to us? Jeremiah chapter 8. I'm reading from verse 20. Jeremiah chapter 8, verse 20. The harvest is past and summer is ended, and we are not saved. They said, we have been waiting for the salvation of the Lord. Thank God, the harvest for you has not ended. Thank God, summer for you has not ended. The time of forgiveness has not ended for you. The time of joy has not ended for you. As they were asking, and they were saying, the harvest is past, the summer is ended, and we are not saved. For the hurt of the daughter of my people are my hurt. I am black, and astonishment has taken hold on me. Is there no balm in Gilead? Is there no physician there? Why then is not the health of the daughter of my people recovered? I'm saying God is here tonight, and God is going to wash you, and God is going to cleanse you. But there'll be a prayer that comes out of your mouth. Already said, call unto me. Call unto me. But he's not going to allow to just say, okay, I'm praying. He will tell you how to pray. When God tells you how to pray, and he says, tell me this. If you say what he has said, miracle will come upon your life. If you say what God has said, you must say, so that salvation will come, and healing will come, and deliverance will come, and power will come, and the promise of God will be fulfilled in your life. I rejoice with you tonight. Are you still there? I said, I rejoice with you tonight. Look at the prayer. Because this prayer is going to be fulfilled according to the promise of God. Jeremiah chapter 17. I'm reading from verse 14. Heal me, O Lord, and I shall be healed. You see, it tells us how to pray. It says, you don't need to do rigmarole. Go here, go there, bend there. It said, say it simple. You say, I'm the sick one. I'm the one having a problem. I'm the one having attack. I'm the one that is poor. I'm the one that needs your help. I'm the one that needs deliverance. I'm the one that needs healing. Heal me, O Lord, and I shall be healed. Look at the next thing there. Save me, and I shall be saved. Save me. That's a prayer you can pray to God. No other person can save you. This man has realized the problem. Now he got the promise. He said, I come with the promise in the presence of God. And I say, nothing in my hand I bring. God, my tears forever flow. God, my zeal no respite, no. All these for sin cannot atone. Can I sacrifice ram? Can I sacrifice pots of oil? Can I burn candle? Can I go to River Jordan? Can I give money to the priest? He says, nothing in my hand I bring. Simply to the cross I cling, because I look at the Lamb of God. Lamb of God, sacrifice for me. Lamb of God that died for me, save me, and I shall be saved. Salvation is available tonight. The promise of salvation for your soul. Why is it that he can save you? That you don't have to bring a sacrifice. You don't have to bring any money. You don't have to bring anything. Jeremiah tells us in chapter 23, in verse 6, Jeremiah chapter 23, verse 6, in his days Judah shall be saved. In the days of Christ, behold the Lamb of God that taketh away the sin of the world. Because Christ has come, in his days Judah shall be saved, and Israel shall dwell safely. This is his name whereby he shall be called the Lord our righteousness. The Lord our righteousness. He said, you come to the Lord and you say, I'm not righteous. I'm a sinner. I'm dirty. I'm defiled. But Jesus has come for me. He's a righteous Savior and he's my righteousness. I give my sin to him. He gives me his righteousness. And I can say now, he's the Lord our righteousness. The Lord our righteousness. The promise of the Lord is, whosoever comes, whosoever comes, coming out of problem, whosoever comes, coming out of darkness, whosoever comes, coming out of the degradation and the shame, whosoever comes unto me, I will in no wise cast off. That's why, as we are coming today, salvation is waiting for you. Forgiveness is waiting for you. Cleansing is waiting for you. Because that's what he said he will do. But you must do something. You must make up your mind. And you must decide. I come out. And when you come out, problems of sin and sickness and suffering over. Tonight I see you free. Tonight I see you saved. Tonight I see you coming out of that evil thing. And as you come out, problems gone, sin gone, condemnation gone. Look at Jeremiah chapter 51. Jeremiah chapter 51, verse 45. My people, go ye out of the midst of her. See what the Lord is saying? He says, I love you. I want to save you. I want to forgive you. I want to bring you among the favored people in heaven. But he said, my people, go ye out of the midst of her. You are part of the thugs. He said, come out of the midst of them. You are part of the wicked, violent people, fighting people. And you have arrows and sword and machete. Anywhere you hear trouble has come, trouble has come, then you take your machete, you go there. He said, you are a child of salvation. You are a child of peace. Drop your machete, come out of them. Anywhere you hear they're doing charm, they're doing occultism, and they're doing magic. You say, give me talisman. You are a child of salvation. He doesn't want you to perish in that condition. You see, after doing all those things, look at what happens to you in the night. Look at all the oppression upon your life, the problem of your sin and suffering. But tonight your deliverance has come, your forgiveness has come. That's why it says in that verse 45, my people, go ye out of the midst of her. Deliver ye every man a soul from the fierce anger of the Lord. Number one, the problem. You are coming out of your problem. Are you there? Am I talking to somebody there? Somebody coming out there? And then number two, the promise of God will meet you on the way. As you stand up, and I say, where are you going? I'm going to Jesus. I'm going to my Savior. He is the Lord, our righteousness. As you are coming, Jesus the Savior will meet you on the way. Forgiveness will meet you on the way. Salvation will meet you on the way. And then power. Help me shout power. I want to hear K2 shouting power. The power of supernatural healing for the sick. Praise the Lord tonight, you are healed. I said, praise the Lord tonight, you are healed. Jeremiah chapter 33. I'm reading here from verse 6. Jeremiah chapter 33, verse 6. Behold, I will bring it health and cure. He said he will bring healing from heaven. I will bring. While you are coming out of the problem, coming out of sin, coming out of suffering, coming out of sickness, coming out of darkness, coming out of occultism, he said, while you are coming, I'll meet you on the way. I'll bring health and cure, and I will cure them. Not only one person. On the right over there, healing. In the center there, healing. On the left over there, healing. Oh, at the back over there, healing. For that child over there, healing. Mama, I see the healing coming. Healing. Papa, deliverance and healing. It's coming your way. I said it's coming your way. Behold, I will bring it health and cure. I will cure them and will reveal unto them the abundance of peace and truth. And then if there's any attack over them, deliverance has come. I said deliverance has come. Tonight you'll sleep like a baby. They were pressing you on the bed, the power of God will drive them away from you. Miracle of healing, miracle of deliverance. Jeremiah chapter 15. I'm reading from verse 21. Jeremiah chapter 15, verse 21. And I will deliver thee. Who is God talking about here? I said, who is God talking about here? The joy of the Lord will never leave your life. And I will deliver thee out of the hand of the wicked. And I will redeem thee out of the hand of the terrible. And that terrible sickness that came upon your life, tonight healing has come. Jeremiah chapter 30, verse 17. For I will restore health unto thee, and I will heal thee of thy wounds. internal wounds of ulcer, he will heal you. Internal sickness of cancer, he will heal you. You will not die of that cancer. Your life is precious in the sight of the Lord. All that issue of blood, tonight it will heal you. For I will restore health unto thee, and I will heal thee of thy wound, says the Lord. Because he called you an outcast, saying, this is Zion, whom no man seeketh after. Your sickness became so terrible that the people that were spending money taking care of you, they have run away. They say they don't know whether you'll ever be healed. They'll see you this week. They'll see you healed. They'll see you delivered. They said, you see it herself? Is it another person? Then you go near. Then you are smiling. Then they mention the name. They say, oh, are you another person? Then you begin to tell them story. Story. This is my story. This is my testimony. Somebody has a testimony there. It will happen to you in Jesus' name. Look at verse 22. And ye shall be my people, and I will be your God. Ye shall be my people, and I will be your God. Can God do it for you tonight? I said, will God do it for you tonight? This problem, will he take it away? This sickness, will he heal this sickness? This infirmity, will he take it away? Anything too hard for God to do? Anything impossible for God to do? Welcome to the miracle arena. Welcome to the supernatural. Welcome to signs and wonders tonight. The promise of God has come to deliver you. Jeremiah chapter 32 verse 17. Ah, Lord God, behold, thou hast made the heaven and the earth by thy great power and thy stretch out arm. And there is nothing too hard for you. And there is nothing too hard for you. Cancer, not hard for God. Paralysis, not hard for God. Blindness, not hard for God. Deafness, not hard for God. Oppression, not hard for God. Tonight, healing has come. Tonight, deliverance has come. Number one, the problem. Number two, the promise. Number three, the power. Those who respond to number one, and you come out of the problem, you say, I want salvation. I want forgiveness. I want the favor of God. I want the forgiveness of God. Number one, you come out of the problem. Jesus, I come. Savior, I come. My Redeemer, I come. As you are coming, the promise of God will meet you by the way. He will forgive you. He will cleanse you. He will save you. He will change your life. You will never be the same again. As the promise of God is coming, the power will follow. The power will follow. Miracle will happen today. Miracle will continue with you during the week. The rest of your life, miracle, miracle, miracle. Child of miracle. Daughter of miracle. Papa is coming your way. Mama is coming your way. My little boy, my little girl is coming your way. You come out of the problem. And then the promise of God will be yes and amen in your life. Are you ready? I said, are you ready? Where are you if you're ready? I said, where are you if you're ready? Heaven is talking to you. Heaven is talking to you. Heaven is saying, this is your day, your day of salvation. He says, this is your day, your day of deliverance. This is your day, the day of power. It's about the eyes closed. You have seen the problem. It's the problem of sin and suffering. If you are saying, I recognize that, I acknowledge that, I confess that, I come out. I come out. Out of the sin. Out of the suffering. I want to partake of the promise of God. I want to partake of the power of salvation. Whatever you are, you raise up your hand. Say, yes, Lord, I am here. A candidate for miracle. A candidate for the miracle of salvation. A candidate for the miracle of forgiveness. Lord, I am here. This is a simple prayer. I'm lost, save me. I'm a sinner, save me. I am bad, make me good. I am defiled, cleanse me. I'm guilty, remove my condemnation. Lord, I come. Nothing in my heart I bring. Jesus is my righteousness. He is the one that died for you, so as to save you and to take your sin away. Tell the Lord. But tell the Lord, I come out. I come out physically, spiritually. I come out of all those bad things. I come out of that sin. I come for your salvation. I come for your salvation. I come for your forgiveness. He will answer your prayer. Call unto me, and I will answer thee, and show you great and mighty things that you knew not. Raise up your hand now. We're going to pray together. Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you for those who have come out of the problem of sin and have said bye-bye to evil. I pray that tonight will be the night of their salvation, the night of their forgiveness. Every condemnation wipe away. Every guilt take away. I pray that your joy of salvation will come to them, and the new life will come to them according to your promise. Save them. Forgive them. Write their names in the book of life. That this night will be a night of joy. That they are now the children of God. And I pray, Lord, your grace will flood their lives. Your grace will fill their lives. And they will not go back to those evil things anymore. Confirm that salvation in their hearts. Thank you, because I know you have answered. In Jesus' name I pray. Praise the Lord. Tonight is that night. It's a night of power. It's a night of miracle. It's a night of signs and wonders. You will not be a spectator. Somebody there, I said, you will not be a spectator. Any sickness there, any infirmity there, any oppression there, any affliction there, the hand of the Lord is touching you right now. Remember the problem. The problem of sin and suffering. Now we've taken care of that problem of sin. Suffering has to leave. Suffering has to run away from you. Sickness has to go away from you. Whatever the name of the sickness, identify it right there. Lay your hand where that problem is. And we're going to pray. The promise of God is sure. He says, I will heal, I will cure, I will deliver. He cannot fail. Raise up your hand if you are waiting for the healing, if you are waiting for the miracle. And then after we pray, you are raising up one hand now. You are laying your hand where you have the problem. Whatever the problem may be, it has to go. Give me a ketu amen over there. It has to go, because power is coming, and power is coming to you right there. If you are blind, your blind eyes will open. If you are lame, you rise up and walk. Any swelling there will vanish away. Cancer will dry up. Ulcer will dry up. HIV AIDS will vanish away. Whatever the name of the sickness, the name of Jesus is greater than them all. You raise up one hand, you lay the other hand on yourself. When you hear the final amen, it is finished. I said it is finished. Are you ready? Father, in Jesus' name, we glorify your name tonight. You are mighty God, the creator of the heavens and the earth, and there is nothing too hard for you. You are promised. You said you will heal. You are promised. You said you will deliver. You are promised. You said I will bring cure. You are promised. You said you will show great and mighty things. Come in your power upon everybody tonight here in Jesus' name. That demonic attack, I command you. Deliverance has come right now. I command that evil spirit, evil power, come out in Jesus' name. That swelling in your body, any part of your body, you see the swelling of cancer, or the swelling of tumor, or the swelling of fibroid, or the swelling of goiter, or the swelling of any other kind of disease, I command that swelling, come out in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray for those of anything they call incurable disease. And you have gone here, you have gone there, you have not been healed. Your healing is coming to you right now. Lord, touch them, heal them in Jesus' name. Let your power strike out that incurable disease. Let your power crush that curse in their lives. Deliver them and break every yoke in Jesus' name. That asthma, I command you, be healed now in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray for those who have issue of blood. That blood has been flowing and flowing and flowing. I command that issue of blood dry up in Jesus' name. All those things walking about in your body, I command that demonic object and that kind of demonic crawling thing in your body, come out in Jesus' name. That curse and spell upon your family, I cancel it in Jesus' name. That pile, I command you, be healed in Jesus' name. Ania, be healed in Jesus' name. The sword that refuses to be healed, I command you to dry up. Be healed in Jesus' name. If you brought anybody deaf and dumb, get them there right now. those deaf ears are opening, the dumb tongue will talk. I command, be healed in Jesus' name. Deaf ears be opened. Deaf ears be opened. Dumb tongues be loosed. Lord, set them free in Jesus' name. I pray for those whose eyes are dim. Cataract in your eyes. Glaucoma in your eyes. Or total blindness. I pray the hand of the Lord will touch you right now. Blind eyes be healed in Jesus' name. Open those eyes and see. Let light come to those eyes. Let sight be brightened right now. Be healed in Jesus' name. Those who have any stroke, or those who are paralysis, or there is your waist that cannot hold you, I send for the power of Christ on your body. Be healed in Jesus' name. Rise up and walk. Let strength come. Let power come. Let the force of heaven come and raise you up right now. Receive your healing in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray for everyone. On my right, healing, miracle, signs and wonders in front of me. Healing, miracle, signs and wonders right to the back. Receive your healing, your miracle, your signs and wonders on the left hand side over there. Healing, miracle, signs and wonders everywhere. Shout of miracle everywhere. Shout of healing everywhere. Shout of deliverance. Receive in Jesus' name. Lord, confirm it everywhere. Thank you because I know it is done. Thank you, Lord, because I know it is done. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Thank God you got it. I said, thank God you got it. I said, thank God you are healed. Thank God you are delivered. He has broken every yoke in your life. Check up, you have a testimony. Check up, your miracle is there. Thank God it has happened to you.